Coach Otis Washington. There's so many things I could say about, as we affectionately called him, Coach Wash. The fondest memory I have of Coach Wash is that he was always so serious when it came to game day. There was never any margin for error. He was a perfectionist. He was a disciplinarian. He was a father figure. He was a man. I mean, Coach Washington literally taught all of his players how to respect themselves, how to honor the school, how to honor the program. But most importantly, he taught us to make sure that we contribute back and that we have a meaningful life. He always believed in each and every one of his players. On a personal note, my father, my family was pretty close to Coach Washington, as my father was his student, was his teacher advisor when he first transitioned into coaching from Woodson Junior High to St. Augustine. And I respected him so much. As in New Orleans, you know, we would call somebody uncle, or it was always the ultimate respect. Coach Wash, Mr. Wash. I don't think ever in life I called him Otis. I never felt that I measured up to the standard that he set. And in the documentary that Ari Craddock produced for Before the West Coast, I was interviewed and I said this one thing. Unfortunately, we lost Kevin Bennett, our quarterback. He died of unexpectedly on the field. And I can vividly remember the courage that Coach Washington had when he walked in that locker room and told us that this young man had passed away. So for so many reasons, Coach Otis Washington will always be a part of my life. I loved him more than a coach. I felt like he was a father figure to me. And I really believe in my heart that a lot of the life lessons and the successes that I've had in life, Mr. Wash has been responsible for a good portion of who Winston Joseph Burns Jr. is, class of 1978. I love you, Mr. Wash. You're always in my heart.
My name is Alfred Dino Hansen. I am from the class of 1987. My relationship and connection with Coach Otis Washington began, I think, as soon as I came out of the womb, thankfully to my uncle, Anthony Neck Simmons, who was one of the assistant coaches here at St. Aug under Coach Wash. And there are two boys that were only ever allowed to ride that purple bus to Pontchartrain Park for football practices, that being myself and Errol Flint. And the thing that has always stood out about Coach Wash, aside from the great creative visionary that he was on the football field, Coach Wash instilled discipline, and I saw this as a little kid. It's really refreshing, although under unfortunate circumstances, that we are here today. But we're paying tribute to a man such as Coach Wash, and I've always said, being a former basketball player, growing up loving football, to be in a room filled with my heroes, to know that as a 7-8-year-old child, my heroes wore this purple and gold. It was about discipline, not only on the field, but off the field. It was about character. It was about a work ethic. It was about family. Coach Wash was a leader of men that were coming here to St. Aug as little boys, that left as men who have gone on to do great things in life, in every aspect of life, not just in athletics, but doctors, lawyers, physicists, everything that embodies the culture that is St. Aug. Coach Wash in St. Augustine High School most certainly made it a point to instill that in us from the moment we walked in this school to the moment we left. And every class at St. Aug will take pride in saying that their class is the best. That is the great thing about this family that is St. Aug. These are things that Coach Otis Washington instilled in every person that came to this school, every person that met him away from the football field. These are qualities that I learned as a little boy, that all I knew was St. Augustine High School. Coach Walsh, you will be missed. Thank you for allowing me to see what it was to be a strong, proud Purple Knight man.
My name is Lenore Ann Collard. I started St. Augustine High School in 1968 in the office, and I remained there till 1989. I remember Otis Washington. Every time he walked into the office, there was that great big smile of his. He was such a loving and endearing person. When I first started St. Augustine, I was right out of high school, so I was relatively young. But Otis came to my assistance and gave me a ride to work every morning, until at which time that I was able to get my own transportation. So that was a plus for me. And Otis was that type of person throughout his days here at St. Augustine High School. The kids loved him. He had so much discipline about him, but yet he was that lovely person, that smiling person, that gregarious person, and always took great pride in St. Augustine High School. We will miss Otis. We will miss him. Linda was so dear. She would have faculty parties, and that was fun. That was a lot of fun, where you could just let your hair down and do what you wanted to do and enjoy yourself, and then you'll get back to the seriousness of teaching or coaching or administrating in the office. So those were great days here at St. Augustine High School.
Mark Moody, class of 1978, proud to be a Purple Knight, proud to have been a student at St. Augustine during the time that Coach Otis Washington was here. He was more than a coach. He was a mentor and a very good example to all the students at St. Augustine. We will miss him dearly.
Hello, my name is Henry Gibson. Class of 1976, I was on the 1975 team with people like Byron Honore, Lewis Holmes, Percy Gibson, my cousin, another cousin, Louis Oubre, Vernell Quinn, and there's so many others. I wish I had time to say all the names and stuff, but the thing I most remember about being on the team was the camaraderie, the unique relationship, the bonds that we had between all the players and the coaches. We had our scuffles and, you know, skirmishes here and there, but for the most part, we all got together and got along, and we all worked for a common goal, and we succeeded in that goal, and that was because of the coaches, like I said, and especially Coach Walsh. He was like a dad figure to all of us, and, you know, he was that calming influence, and he inspired a lot of us. When he came in the locker room at halftime and gave those fiery speeches, you could just feel it. And when, after he spoke and, you know, told us the good things we did, and but a lot of the bad things we did too, after he spoke, you know, we just came out there renewed and with a vigor that you couldn't believe. It was like you could knock a wall down, and he made you he inspired you to do the best you could and to go beyond the best you could do. And that's the main thing I can remember about him, the fiery speeches, the larger than life figure that he was, and just having him on that team, you know, being the captain of the helm of that ship, that meant the world to all of us, all our teammates and stuff. And I just wanted to say it was a pleasure to be on that team and to be one of the student athletes under him, and I thank his wife, and she was a marvelous person too. And, you know, that year was a very special year, and, you know, because of him, Coach Flynn, Simmons, and, you know, so many others, because of them, you know, that's the reason why we're here today, to honor this person who was a great man, a great coach, great individual, and like I said, a father figure. And he meant the world to us. And God bless you, God bless you, God bless you, Coach Otis.
My name is Hiram Nurse. I'm graduating class of 74-75 at St. Augustine High School. Coach Walsh was a fantastic coach. He was inspirational to a lot of young men. He's so much of a icon to this school, to this state, and to this city. We have many good memories of Coach Walsh. One that I recall is that Coach Walsh had a hard time cursing. He couldn't do it well, so we laughed every time he cursed. And because of that, we would sometimes get in a little bit more trouble than we were already in. But I love the man. I know so many of us love him. But the most important thing about Coach Walsh's life, I think, as far as St. Augustine is concerned, it was in a time of transition. The racial climate was that of tension and some discourse. But I remember him telling us on the field that wasn't our problem. That wasn't our source of energy. What we were to do was to play the best we could, as honest as we could, and as hard as we could. He taught that, we received it, we understood it, and we performed. And because of that, it made me a better man. It made me a better citizen. I now can go places, do things, and fight the odds that are against me. I remember him saying, I want you to go on that field. And it's not first and 10, first and 25. Because they know, we know, that they're going to take something from us. But don't fret, don't get angry. When they call you a racial slur or call a bad call, deal with it. Go back to the huddle and let's do it again. Coach Walsh, I want to thank you for that. The family of St. Augustine wants to thank you for that. The city, and I would say state and nation, in that time, should thank you for what you've done. Thank you very much.
Hi, my name is Nathaniel Jones. I'm the current head football coach at St. Augustine High School. Just want to say a few words about Coach Walsh. Outstanding gentleman. Had the opportunity to meet him on several occasions. Just really embodies what a coach should be. You know, he was trying to pour into me when we met, and I could see his genuine love for young people. And, you know, he told me about some of the challenges that I might face at St. Augustine, and, you know, just to be strong and, you know, follow my convictions, and just was really helpful to me. And, you know, I just really love the person that I got to know, and even though it was brief, but very inspirational in my development as a coach and as a man.
My name is Eddie Compass, class of 1976. My fondest memories of Coach Washington is not just with St. Augustine, but after we graduated from St. Augustine and I worked with him to Police Athletic League. He took a program and, like he did at St. Aug, made us championship football teams. He made that program the model for the entire nation. We had over 500 kids involved in that program. But it wasn't just teaching kids athletics and teaching them life lessons. He saved lives. We had kids that were at risk, that was in a process of going to jail, in a process of being in gangs, in a process of getting on drugs. And Mr. Walsh changed that. He had an impact on these kids like he had on the football teams at St. Augustine High School. People look at Otis Washington as a great football coach, but he was even a greater man, and he will be truly missed. I love you, Mr. Walsh.
Hey, my name is Juan Jackson. I graduated in 1980. I played on 1978-79 state championship football teams, and I also ran track for St. Aug. Coach Tony Villegas was my coach. My senior year, I was MVP in track. The best memory that I have that has helped me in my life is we were taught that we had to play the other team, and we also had to beat the officials, and that we were not going to have a bad attitude regardless to whatever happened. We were taught to stay focused. We were taught to face the unexpected adversity. one of the best experiences of my whole life was to be a graduate of St. Augustine Purple Knights. And the example that Coach Washington gave us was incredible. And I'm honored to have been here.
Yeah, it's also the Good Morning Show on WBOK, man. It was just a great honor to pay tribute to Coach Wash, his legacy. This morning we had Roe Brown, Roy Glapion, Oy Craddock, and Chief Eddie Compass, man, just paying tribute to a man who was more than a coach. Even though I didn't play ball for Coach Washington, but I competed against him and his teams, his legacy and his impact as a mentor, a man, and a coach stretched all the way to my school, my family, and what I try to do when we mentor and teach young men. So when you have that type of greatness, never really gone and definitely never really forgotten. Love and peace always, not only to Coach Wash, but to everybody he touched.
Hello, my name is Lewis Holmes. I'm a graduate of the 1975 state championship football team and a graduate of St. Augustine 1976. Coach Otis Washington showed me a lot of care, concern, and gave me a lot of information to keep me rolling. He took put a lot of faith in me to make me the starting quarterback of the state championship football team. I really did appreciate that. Coach Washington always put us first. Every student, every play, every thought was always first in his mind to give and share to us. He was always a giving man. We're gonna miss him. Rest in peace, Coach.
Hi, this is Cameron Gaston, class of 72. I was a football player under Coach Otis Washington. Was one of the greatest pleasures and one of the greatest motivators in my life at that time. He pushed us to do things that we didn't think we could do, but he also pushed us and showed us about the hard work, determination, and not giving up. I was a center on his 1971 football team. Of course, we lost to Brother Martin, unfortunately, but other than that, nobody expected a lot out of us, I don't think, but we kept driving and he kept pushing us, and that lessons that we got through Coach Wash, through football, allowed us, I think, a lot of guys to become what they are today, so that anything that was tough out there, we was ready for it, because we always felt like it was us against the world back then. Coach Wash, I'll miss you, love you, you know, and thanks for being that other dad, because when I wasn't at home, because my dad was almost the same, you know, there you were. And thanks for making a big impact on my life.
My name is James Wagner, and class of 80 at St. Aug. I was fortunate enough to play under Coach Wash on his final two seasons at St. Aug, two state championship seasons in 78 and 79. And I was also blessed to be able to go play at LSU when Coach Wash was coaching at LSU. And Coach Wash was a phenomenal man. The one thing that I remember most about him was he was a disciplinarian. He kept us in line all the time. And he was just a blessing to not only myself, but a lot of the young men at St. Aug. And his wife, Miss Linda, was my Sunday school teacher back in Sunday school. So it's just a blessing to be here for a celebration. And I just thank everything that he's done for me in my life.
My name is Carlos Hornbrook. Coach Washington coached me at LSU. We the other purple and gold family here for him. One thing Coach taught me is that you know everybody can have a great team and great players, but you got to know how to pick their talent. And Coach Washington was able to get the best talent out the worst player, and put them in a great situation to survive and win. And that's what it's all about. And Coach Washington, such an individual, I never met a person that affected so many lives like Coach Washington has. And it was an honor to know him. And God bless. Go Coach Wash.
Hi, I'm Lyman White, really out of Franklin, Louisiana. I first met Coach Washington when his first year he came to LSU in 1979, 1980, which was my senior year. And he coached the offensive lineman. I was a defensive they call it in outside linebacker, and I really taught him that his offensive lineman couldn't block me. So that was my purpose of letting him know they couldn't block me. Now, but Coach Walsh was one of the best men I ever met. He, when he got to LSU, it was a different experience for me because it was the first time we had black coaches at LSU. My first 3 years, we had no black coaches on the staff, and Coach Bishop Harris came first, and a few weeks later, they brought Coach Walsh in, and we lost Bo Ryan. So that at that moment, we went from Bo Ryan to Coach Bishop Harris, Otis Washington, to Jerry Stovall being our head coach. I had a chance to play my senior year with Coach Walsh, who really was a wonderful man, a wonderful human being. I'd never seen a man so loved and respected by his players like Marcus Quinn, Malcolm Scott. I got a chance to know them guys and play with those guys. But Coach Walsh was one of the best men I ever known. One of the best men that walked all the way from Selma, Alabama. He made a mark in Louisiana. Thank you, Coach Walsh.
Hello, C.J. Charbonnet, 1973. Look, make this short and sweet. Coach Otis Washington meant so much to me. I never played football for him or anything like that, but I was one of his history students that I taught. He taught me in class at St. Aug. And I used to just like talking to him on the side. So I told him one time, I said, Coach, I said, what is like your success, your success to being so successful in football? He called me CB. That's what he called me. CB, damn you, CB. He said, CB, my best 11 athletes goes on defense. God damn it if they can't score. God damn it, they can't win. And I'll never forget that as long as I live. And that's why we always had the best defenses when Otis was there and under Eddie Flint and stuff too. Thank y'all, Coach Washington. Love you. Gonna miss you, Otis. Thank you.